In this video, I'm going to show you how to screen record in OBS Studio. By the end of this video, you'll be able to screen record with a simple keyboard shortcut, and you'll even be able to include your webcam, your microphone, and even your internal computer audio. Just make sure you watch to the very end so you don't miss anything. Let's go. All right, let's jump right in. First off, you can download and install OBS Studio at obsproject.com. Once installed, just open it up, and the first thing you'll want to do is open up settings. Here we'll configure output, audio, and some hotkeys. So first, click output and make sure you set the recording path. I have mine set to videos. This is where it'll save all your recordings on your computer, and it's nice to just have that set up and know where it's putting the files. So definitely make sure you set that up. Next, set the recording quality to high quality and change the recording format to MP4. Why MP4? Well, MP4 is the most universal video format and is supported by just about everything. Here, if you have the option available, choose H.264, which is a universal format. But if you have a computer without a fancy graphics card like mine, you can always choose this software option. Now open up audio. I have my desktop audio and mic audio set to default. And you can always come here and try selecting a specific device if your sound isn't working. For example, I have two microphones plugged into this computer, so I can tell it which one to use. But I'll just leave it at default for now. Now open up hotkeys. I recommend setting up a shortcut to start recording and stop recording. And you can really make this anything you want, so I'll just use F10 because that's pretty easy to remember. And we're all set for now, just click OK. Now from here, you'll want to add a new source to this empty scene that you start with. Click this little plus here under sources, and now you can choose what you actually want to capture. You can capture a specific window if you want, or you can capture the whole screen, which is what we're going to choose for this tutorial. So select display capture and then click OK. Keep capture method set to automatic, and here you can choose which display you want to capture. I'll choose my primary monitor. If you have an HDR display like mine, you might notice it looks a little hazy, so you can check Force SDR to correct the colors for OBS, and then click OK. Next, right-click the preview area and click Resize Output Source Size, and then click Yes. And now you should see everything on your screen in this little window if you didn't before. Now open up settings one more time and go to video this time. And here we can set the saved output video size. You can choose 1920 by 1080 for high definition or HD, or 3840 by 2160 for 4K video if your monitor supports it. 1920 is perfectly fine for most people, but if you want 4K content, then choose 3840. Just know that the file size is going to be 4 times larger. I'll just go with 1920 for this tutorial, and then click OK. Now from here, if you want to add a webcam, you can add another source by clicking plus under sources, and then choose video capture device and click OK. Here you can choose your webcam, and mine's currently not active, but click OK and just imagine this is your live webcam, and you can move and resize this wherever you want. I'll remove this for now though, but I just wanted to show you how you can add your webcam if you wanted. And last thing before we record, here you can see the audio levels coming in, and you might want to slide your desktop audio down a bit if you're also recording your voice, so your voice isn't drowned out by the computer's audio. And just make sure your mic's audio isn't cutting into this red here when you talk. If it exceeds 0 decibels, it's going to start to clip and just sound really bad. Now we can press start recording or hit F10 to start recording. And now we are recording. So I'll just pull up one of my videos to use as an example.
In this video, I'm gonna share with you 10 of the absolute best free tools you can use to create videos for YouTube.
And now I'll hit F10 to stop recording. And now if we open up videos in Explorer, here's our recorded video file. So let's just open this with Media Player and boom, there we go. Mission accomplished. Here's our screen recording with internal computer audio.
The absolute best free tools you can use to create videos for YouTube.
Now, I know that was a lot of steps, so here's everything in one place and you can just pause here if you need to. By the way, if you're getting value out of this video, hit like, subscribe, and tap the notification bell to get more valuable content like this. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. And if you want to learn the best free resources for making YouTube videos, then check out this video next. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in this next video.